So much. We have a special guest speaker today, Dr. Tabrizi, Dr. Mariam Tabrizi, who is at the University of Texas Health Sciences at Houston. She is the very first dentist, very first geriatric dentist at that, to be a speaker at Project ECHO. Oral health is so very important for everyone, and particularly for older adults. So I'm very appreciative that you are willing to come and speak to us today, Dr. Tabrizi, and I really look forward to hearing your talk.
Dr. Bennett, it's a pleasure, it's an honor, and I will not take this lightly. You, as you said, oral health is a huge part of overall health, and this opportunity is priceless. And with that, I move on so I can respectfully keep on time. Okay, this is me. This is very quick thing, just my email address in case anybody has any questions later on after the presentation is done. The objective today I recognize this presentation is for non-dental primary providers and residents. So it's all about assessing, assessment of oral health, meaning just looking at the mouth and recognize whatever it is that does not look normal. I kind of categorized it in good, bad, and ugly, and because there are some ageism that changes the oral health, and it's not always a disease, but some of them need attention, some don't. They're just aging process. The first thing we can look, it's just number of plaque, amount of plaque, broken teeth, or looking at cheeks, tongue, lip, gums, anything that does not look normal. Sometimes looking at the tongue, we all know that that kind of layer, which in this case was a fungus infection, is not normal. A lot of times we think if elderly individuals don't have teeth, well, there is no reason for dentists, but there is a lot of other issues that requires actually oral health is more than just teeth. In this case down here, this person in a hospice care actually just stopped eating, and nobody knew why, because she couldn't obviously express herself. And all it was, a fractured porcelain crown caused a very traumatizing big cut here. And the pain was so bad that she just basically couldn't put food in her mouth. And of course, when we look at soft tissue recession, which is part of ageism, but once those receded areas, which are on the cementum, the layer of the teeth changes, they are much more prone to caries. So basically just looking at what doesn't look normal. This population, as we all know, are at highest risk. Why? Due to lack of oral hygiene, lack of care for them, because those who actually care for these people are not trained for oral health. And oral health is not, when somebody is that sick and need have those kind of other needs, oral health normally is not a priority. And yet it puts them in such a heartbreaking and horrible health conditions that starts from oral health can easily be avoided and prevented. The things to look for are exteriorly facial structure. If they don't have teeth, they usually collapse the lips, the cheeks, the whole faces. Diastemas take place sometimes due to bruxism. Bruxism leads to a lot of other myofascial pain and issues. oral hygiene is a huge thing. Fractured teeth, falls, usually when people fall, the first thing they hit most of the time is their face. When we see bruising on the face, it's okay to look at the teeth and see if any other damage was done. Oral lesions. Oral lesion happens a lot. If it's not cancer, it can be due to a lot of things. Dryness of a tissue causes a lot of lesions that can happen with just cut, trauma, sometimes as a result of ill-fitting dentures, prosthesis, large cavities, and sometimes the old fillings and dental materials put in the fillings, they fall out. And sometimes they just recurring caries take place, cavities take place, and sometimes they cause trauma to other soft tissues, like I showed you in that lower lip. Dryness, salivary flow decreasing is part of ageism, because the glands, salivary glands start decreasing in function and amount of saliva to begin with. And combine that with 470 other medications that xerostomia is a side effect, and a lot of other over-the-counter medications, prescribed medications, it leads to a lot of dryness that accumulates plaque, which in normal people's saliva is a cleansing element, and in these people doesn't exist enough of it. This person was just coming out of a bad stroke, was in a nursing home for a rehab. When we found out that her gum disease was so advanced that teeth were actually not just mobile, but coming out of her mouth. She was on a heavy duty dose of blood thinners. It was not an easy thing to do, but we had to actually be able to remove a lot of these teeth, because the amount of bacteria in the mouth that could hurt her overall was astronomical. Let's start with the good. I'm trying to keep all this in time. Good is discoloration, sometimes out of line. Bruxism can cause some diastema, some wear, tear and wear due to ageism. Sometimes recession can take place above the old cronon bridge. When this happens, it exposes a softer part of a tooth, which is the root part and a cementum, more vulnerable to cavities. And when that happens, it's all domino effect, unfortunately. Once the recession happens, dryness happens, cavities happens, gum disease happens, it's all combined to become multiple layers of oral disease. And as patients get older, especially if we fit this in a 4Ms, as they get into mentation decline, mobility decline, medications increase, process just gets harder and harder, and more issues and problems. Like this case, this was a patient in an elderly in a nursing home who was on heavy duty beta blockers. Beta blockers, well, one of the side effects is tissue overgrowth. Tissue overgrowth, it gets to the point when the teeth break, like he had two actually broken roots here, completely covered with tissue, overgrown tissue, that you couldn't see them. As a result, he had a lot of soft tissue abscess. This man was hurting so much everywhere all around here. The only reason we were called in, because he stopped eating and his wife decided, well, it might be his teeth. And sure enough, when we got there, this is what we found. sometimes the problem, as bad as these teeth look, they're not really bad. There's a lot of stain, there's a lot of recessions, there are some newly forming caries. These are preventable before they break at certain point and lead to harder problems and more difficult issues. It's very difficult to deal with extraction and more advanced and invasive oral treatment, again, because they don't heal properly. They are on so many medications that we have to be careful with so many things. Fractures, again, I had to put this out on, can cause a lot of other issues. So just looking at the mouth, that assessment can save lives. Trauma, big trauma here. All it was, she lost her upper denture and the lower teeth were basically going into this soft tissue and causing this huge inflammation, painful, and actually right here, there was a lesion there. Again, lack of vertical dimension causes angular colitis here that actually is the best area for bacteria to form. Oral hygiene is, I can't tell you enough how neglectful it is. And a lot of times when patients go to hospital for aspiration pneumonia, most of the time, 750 different type of bacteria in the mouth can be found in the lungs. I'm sure if one of us has enough funding to actually collect data on that area, we can see this, how bad this could be. And then the ugly is, of course, the oral lesion that can actually be cancerous. It's very easy to see this in a first stage rather than at this stage that with the aggressive treatment and surgery, it can be a very hard thing to live with. This is nothing but a irritation from this fractured tooth here. I usually ask these questions, what do you think it is? We don't have the time, but this is nothing but a lesion that this end of a tongue was very, again, painful, and it was caused just by the fractured tooth. Lack of eating, pushing teeth away, loose, ill-fitted oral prosthesis can usually cause a lot of malnutrition in the elderly. Denture broke again, implants are exposed. This woman was the one actually with the angular colitis. She was a very, very sick person when I got to her. It took quite a few visits to be able to address her and give her actually a proper denture. And 2 months later, the new denture was lost. Loose prosthesis can be swallowed sometimes. That's the back of a throat is actually a piece of a tooth hanging on this partial denture. There's a lot can be, we call them the ugly part of a geriatric oral health, but a lot of these can be really be caught by primary physicians just with a very basic assessment. This is a fall. This tooth was actually totally out of tissue because when she was, they actually saw the addressed the lesions and bruising after the fall. But the daughter of this person called us later because days after, as you can see, the bruise is old looking bruise. We were called in only because she still couldn't eat, and that's where we found when we get it was the tooth right in the front, half of it out, and very, very painful. Dental pain in elderly is more common than you can ever imagine. This is the last one, and I just want to say that how well-fitted oral health can fall into our four ends, whether in a hospital workflow or primary office workflow. Just as we can take that baseline history, oral health can be just part of that, and everything, the oral health and overall health, can actually flow together at the same time. And the questions, I believe, are going to be waiting for till the end. Unfortunately, I have to run to a clinic. We had a few faculty out today, and I was placed in a clinic. I have to go. But please email me, call me, all my information on these. I'll be more than happy to talk to you about any of the cases I showed.